All content is publicly sourced and used under the USA Fair Use and UK Fair Dealing Guidelines. The things I say are strictly my opinion. Good morning, everyone. It's the Bizzy Bee with the Royalty. It is the 30th of June. Happy Wednesday to you. Halfway through the week. Today's the last day of the month, right? Oh, yes. Tomorrow's the 1st. You know what the 1st is, right? I don't need to say anymore. I wanted to post this video yesterday, but yesterday was a crazy day. Let me tell you what happened. I went to see a nutritionist yesterday. I told you all a few videos ago how I've gained a little weight. Well, this nutritionist, she was really good. I learned a lot of things that I thought were not true about food and vice versa. I'm not going to get all into it because me and her talked for over an hour. But one thing I will say that she told me was it's not necessary to eat breakfast. And I said, but my grandmother and mother always told me it's the most important meal. She said, no, that's not true. She said, most people, you know, they think they have to eat breakfast because that's what they're supposed to do, and they force themselves to eat it, and it's not good. You should only eat when you're hungry and not force yourself to eat breakfast, because that's one thing that I do is I force myself to eat something before I start work in the mornings, even if I'm not hungry. So she said I need to knock that junk off. Anyway, so let's start talking about the Harkles. There's a few things going on here, and if you know anything about royal history, which I'm sure you do, that's why you're watching this. Oh, first of all, let me show you my social media info. If you want to chat, there you go. And also, tips are greatly appreciated. There's my PayPal info. It really does help me. Okay. So now we have a picture of Smegs up, we can start talking about the Harkles. All right, if you know anything about royal history, I'm sure you do because you're watching this, you know that the Queen Mother, the mother of the current Queen, Elizabeth Bowes Lyon was her name. She's married to George VI. Anyway, she refused to say Wallace Simpson's name. She would call her that woman. Well, Meghan has earned her own nickname from Prince William, and it's based on the Queen Mother's nickname for Mrs. Simpson. It's that bloody woman. Prince William called Meghan that bloody woman after the royal funeral. Relations between William and Harry remain frosty over Meg's, despite rumors that they had reconciled at the funeral of their grandfather. Although family and friends had hoped the funeral of Prince Philip would bring the brothers together, William is uncompromising, calling Meghan that bloody woman in a conversation with friends. But look at the way that bloody woman treated my staff. Merciless, Prince William said, according to a royal source cited by the Daily Mail. Relations between the brothers have been distant since last year when Meg and Hare left the royal family, moving first to Canada, then to L.A., they reportedly worsened after Harry participated in his Oprah interview in March. There they were, at each other's throats as fiercely as ever, said a friend of the brothers describing their meeting. The rage and anger between those two has grown so incredibly deep. Too many harsh and wounding things have been said. The brothers are scheduled to reunite Thursday for a memorial to their mother, Princess Diana, who was killed in an accident in Paris in 1997. Oh, goodness, tomorrow is the 1st of July. I said that just a few minutes ago, didn't I? But that the statue unveiling is tomorrow. I completely forgotten about that. Oh, my goodness, we're going to have a lot to talk about tomorrow. Wish I could be a fly on that wall. Oh, wow. There's going to be some arguing going on back there, and Meghan's not going to be there. Say whatever they want. Oh, Harry's not going to have Meghan there to protect him. Oh, goodness, who's going to protect him from mean William? Oh, dear me. Okay, Harry wants a reconciliation with William, but Meghan's not budging, and she's not going to allow him to reconcile with his brother. Harry's ready to admit mistakes of sheer temper, but Meg's and Prince William will not give ground in efforts to mend the royal rift. The two princes will see each other on Thursday after Prince Philip's funeral reportedly failed to meaningfully repair the damaged relationship. The brothers will be side by side at the unveiling of a statue in their mother's honor at Kensington Palace, creating a new opportunity for progress in negotiations. Here we go with Robert Lacey again. He's got this book that he's trying to push, and he's got this false narrative. Oh, I'm so sick of hearing about him. Robert Lacey charted the Royal Rift in his bombshell biography, Battle of Brothers. That's the name of the book, which detailed how William threw Harry out of Kensington Palace over B-U-L-L-Y-I-N-G allegations against Megs. However, out of the three royals, it is Harry who is most ready to admit fault, the historian says. He told Newsweek, "What's interesting is that on one side, we've got William, who doesn't seem prepared to concede anything, and on the other side, friends have told me that Harry wouldn't mind reconciling, and then it's Meghan who is sticking to her G-U-N-S on this issue. It should surely be possible," he continued, "for both sides to say the past is the past. It's very regrettable that Megs doesn't withdraw just a little." Megs be withdrawn? Are you kidding me? That's the biggest joke I've ever heard. I don't think so. Why can't she say it was the pressure? "I was getting used to this incredibly complicated system. I was just pregnant. I couldn't sleep. I was wondering about all night firing off emails. Perhaps in retrospect, I went over the top about it." Meghan was accused of using the B word against two personal assistants out of the royal household and targeting a third member of staff in an email sent by Communications Secretary Jason Nauf in October 2018. A story leaked to the Sunday Times that December suggested Meghan's staff found her difficult to work. Meghan, difficult? Where do they get this stuff from? It's like they're pulling this out of the air. To work for, and stated she would fire off email demands as early as 5 a.m. Well, now, I can understand being up early, but I'm certainly not emailing people at 5 a.m. My alarm goes off about 4. That's what time the dogs get up anyway. But I'm definitely not emailing orders to folks, and even if I had folks that worked for me, I wouldn't be sending them emails at 5 a.m. No. I wouldn't begin before 8, I promise. More recently, there have been reports in UK newspapers of staff left shaking or in tears after a dressing down from Megs. Lacey's book details how internally the B-U-L-L-Y allegations caused a fierce argument between William, who backed his staff, and Harry, who backed his wife. Battle of Brothers quoted a friend who said it led to William throwing Harry and Meghan out of Kensington Palace with the Sussex splitting off to form a new office at Buckingham Palace in March of 2019. However, even Harry and Meg's exit from royal life did not put the issue behind them, as Meg's return to the dispute during her court case against UK newspaper The Mail on Sunday. Lawyers for the Duchess told the High Court in London she was left unprotected by the institution while she was pregnant in summer 2020. When the couple's Oprah interview was announced earlier this year, Nauf's email alleging the B-U-L-L-Y word was leaked to the Times. Meghan then leveled darning allegations in the primetime tell-all, accusing the palace of leaking false stories about her and denying her access to a mental hospital while she was thinking about offing herself. Despite the explosive allegations on both sides, Lacey says Harry is prepared to concede mistakes privately to friends. He told Newsweek, "Harry is prepared to acknowledge the role that just sheer temper played at unfortunate moments, notably in the so-called blindsiding early in 2020. He actually is prepared to admit, in a way that William doesn't seem to be, the fact that both of them are irascible, both of them are short-tempered, both of them are Spencers, if you like." Spencer is Princess Diana's family name. FYI, I'm sure you already knew that, though. Harry was accused of blindsiding Queen Elizabeth II by sources quoted in the British media when he published his plans to quit the royal family at short notice in January 2020. However, Lacey said the time had come for the two brothers and Meg to put the past including the B-word allegations behind them. There must be a way of playing it down, surely, and just moving forward, Lacey continued. It's not as if Meg's employing any royal staff anymore. She's living in a different country. It's not a live issue, so it would be good, it seems to me, if she could find a way of just putting it to bed. Meghan doesn't put issues to bed very easily. She goes to bed very easily, but she doesn't put something to bed very easily. No, she hangs on to that grudge. However, the author also suggested she's like a little pit bull hanging onto that grudge. When them jaws lock down, she just won't let go. The author suggested William and Kate may feel vindicated in relation to the doubts they had early in Harry's relationship. Battle of Brothers describes how William urged Harry to slow down early in the relationship with Meg, but the advice did not go down well. Lacey told Newsweek, We know now that William had his doubts from a very early stage about at least whether Meghan would fit into the system, where Meghan had the right personality for the system and the situation, and that's the sort of thing he would have discussed with Kate, and she endorsed it. Kate shared his doubts and question mark from the beginning. Events would seem to have borne them out. Meghan wasn't the right sort of person to fit into the protocols of the British royal family. There's a very fair case to say, why should she? She's a self-made woman, and why should she put up with it all? Why should she put up with it? She chose to marry into it. Let me tell you all something. I was watching a documentary about Queen Elizabeth II last night, and they were talking about how she doesn't consider herself to be the one that these world leaders are coming there to meet. They're coming there to meet the crown. They're not coming there for her. They're coming there for the monarch, and she is the one who happens to be filling that spot at the moment, but she doesn't look at herself as a celebrity. You don't go into the royal family wanting to be a celebrity, wanting to be world famous. You go in there trying to blend in with the rest, trying to do the duty. You don't want to be the star of the show, and that's what Meghan's wanted from the very beginning, and to make a few bucks off the whole thing. She's pretty good at that. Let me share with you a few interesting comments I found about the thing I just read to you. Okay, number one, it looks like Meg is very passive-aggressive. And how is this marriage healthy when it appears she is pulling all the strings and has managed to isolate Harry from all his family and friends? Meghan was the wrong choice of wife for a royal. She is a strong, independent woman, and clearly the restricted life of royalty was not for her. I give this marriage 5 more years, 10 max. Her manipulative and controlling ways will wear thin after a while, and Harry will split. Next comment. Lacey has done a 180 from his original book. There could be no kiss and makeup for William. The California couple not only gave the interview to Lady O while the patriarch of the family lay dying, they lied. All capital letters for lied. 18 times, from the inconsequential to the monumental, Markle deliberately targeted William's wife. For a self-styled feminist, this is not a good look. Whether William can ever forgive Harry personally is one thing. William is the future king, and Harry cannot be trusted. Any man who turns on his family to placate his wife, who is angry because she cannot have the starring role in the family, is a man to keep at arm's length or farther. Third comment. Let's talk about the outfit for the Oprah interview, which was constructed by her and or her team to look like the same picture of Wallace Simpson. There we go with Wallace Simpson again. She's got that woman down pat, doesn't she? She certainly has a lot in common with her. Okay, Wallace Simpson. Google it if you don't know. That's what the comment says, not me. In order to portray herself as the victim, same hairstyle, same dress, and she wonders why we don't like her. What a manipulator. And the last comment. Harry is just sucking up so as not to lose the Sussex titles. Come into my parlor, said the spider to the fly, and the queen is falling for it. The palace has catered to him time and time again. What Harry wants, Harry gets. Beware, William. Oh my goodness, what a mouthful today, right guys? Well, it's almost 8:30 and that is the magic hour when I have to start work, everyone. So I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, subscribe, comment, share, and hit the notification button. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a great Wednesday, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.